Following in the footsteps of the recently updated Toyota Hilux is the 2021 Toyota Fortuner. It continues to share its heavy-duty platform and gets the revised turbo diesel engine. It also shares some fundamental dimensions and interior elements. Like the Hilux, the Fortuner receives a freshened up exterior design for 2021. You might notice the new look headlights at the front, which are thinner and feature LED technology, and there's a larger black grille in the middle. Toyota has also altered the lower apron to include a skid plate style trim. Underneath, the rear suspension continues with the comfortable coil spring arrangement over the Hilux's more heavy-duty leaf spring setup. Most of the important bits continue to feature protection plates, while the ground clearance remains at 216 millimeters. Although it seems like there's a lot more than that. Here we're testing the base model GX, which comes standard with 17-inch alloy wheels. These replace the somewhat appealing steel wheels in the previous model. It is a pretty basic cabin inside, especially in GX form, but it's all very user-friendly and ideal for busy families. This test vehicle shows off the fully molded rubber floor mats, which certainly come in handy during off-road excursions. Up on the dash is Toyota's latest 8-inch touchscreen media interface, which is standard across the range. It supports Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, and includes a rear-view camera even on this base model. The GX model gets a durable fabric trim covering the reasonably comfortable seats. Passenger space in the second row is very good. Impressively, all three rows get their own climate vents too, mounted in the ceiling. Accessing the third row is relatively easy thanks to a flip-up seat mechanism, which opens up a clear pathway. Third row seating is respectable for this class, however, there are some SUVs in this segment that offer more space. Getting rid of the third row is a bit of a hassle. The seats don't fold flush into the floor, but instead hang from the side in the boot area. The boot floor isn't completely flat either, but there's certainly enough volume for all the family, even with the third row in place. As for the engine, it now produces a very decent 150 kilowatts and 500 newton meters. We knew it was going to be quicker than the previous model, but we weren't expecting it to be this much quicker. In saying that, it's now about as quick as most crossover style diesel SUVs in this class. The new engine is also slightly more refined and quieter than before. This is what it goes like.